In this story, this person said that when I was 2 or 3, I was talking to my grandmother and told her that my mom and dad weren't my real mom and dad. My grandmother, knowing this wasn't true, said they were. I calmly explained that no, my real mom and dad were killed when the bad men came. I had to live because my mom hid me behind a rock. I then went on to describe white men with guns and us dark people with long hair. When I was done, I went back to eating my ice cream. You know, that's what really makes kids adorable and sweet and absolutely terrifying is that they say things, but they don't really understand what they're saying, and they can be doing anything, yeah, like eating ice cream. Oh, this ice cream is so good. My other dad was so big.
No way. Is this Bray Wyatt?
This next one
this
is super
is.
Short,
I'm facing my brother.
One of the
There's no way I'm facing my brother.
I am not Bray Wyatt. I'm not Harry.
Shut up. No, Randy Orton is not my brother, Bray Wyatt, but their family. Oh my gosh! I'm against my brother in real life. Randy Orton is Bray Wyatt, and turning your backs on each other.
Orton!
Get up! And you're eliminated. I'm sorry, Bray, but we were friends. But don't talk to me,
you know. This girl asked my little sister why, and her little sister said, I watched your sons burn up the fire in your screams.
Oh no! We are enemies. I mean enemies. Oh crap.
Finally, a teacher posted this story about her
father. Oh, our girl! To get this job. And you're gonna be eliminated by Randy Orton. And eliminated. Let's go.
She said, also your parents say you act like your dad's brother. Then the kid looks at her so seriously and says, I am my dad's brother. I remember all about him as a kid.
Curtis Axel. Another superstar's kind of joke is coming.
I couldn't stand his music. I still like him. He then proceeded to tell his teacher the price for
calling
the TV shows they used to watch like Wild and Crazy Kids on Nickelodeon. When she asked him if he talked about this at home, he said, yes, it makes my mommy cry. And Donnie, or I guess he's my dad, keeps saying he can't believe it, but I know he does. I sit at dinner sometimes and go over all the things I used to do to him. So I hope we all learn something.
Bye, Curtix! Bye!
Brother, sister, cousin, whatever. And when they randomly say something creepy, and they will, just smile, tell them it's nice, give them some ice cream, and
move on.
Because you know what? Peeing your
like
pants
now,
is not that fun.
First time being
more serious.
Neville! The Cruiserweight! The Cruiserweight champion! He won the Cruiserweight champion tonight. Against Rick Storm. Now he's gonna attack.
So if you want to know more about that, then check out my video right here. Thanks for watching, everybody. See you later.
Dark Angel to Neville! And Neville's gonna get eliminated. Oh, crap!
Hey everyone, it's Mikey Chen. So if you've been watching this channel for a while now, you know that I love to explore the topic of reincarnation. Which is a concept that is commonplace in many Eastern beliefs. These belief systems also talk about the existence of a third eye, an invisible eye that is able to see things that people believe this dimension.
Because I just eliminated Neville again.
The scriptures also say that we are all born with this eye.
Beat Rick Swan or something. Or our truth. I'm gonna beat him up.
The scriptures also mention that because
children's
minds are so pure,
why did you even do
this?
That was a bad idea.
So keeping that in mind, here are some of the creepiest things that kids have actually said. And of course, I can't verify whether these things actually happened or not, but I choose to believe that most people are not so dark that they just sit around all day and look at these things. Also, I just want to say, anytime something creepy has to do with a kid, it becomes way creepier. I mean, taking this famous scene.
My brother again, but
right? No,
we are enemies now.
Doesn't that make a huge difference? So just a warning, some of the stuff that these kids say is pretty scary. I mean, I've got multiple times making this video.
No, you're not looking at me.
So, just a warning, don't watch this alone at night. Or, you know, I can
get
involved. It is not scary at all. Number one,
she
left that with his mother.
We should be buddies.
One day, the family was
panicking. Yeah! Get in the corner! Get in the corner! Get in the corner!
The dad and the older brother followed him. Now, the family is to a large headstone that's simply ready here lies Austin. There's no dates or anything else on the tombstone. The person close to this story also noted that his brother did not go to read until he was six, and this headstone wasn't even visible from where they were.
That was a bad idea, Diego.
First of all, why any family would have a picnic by the cemetery? I don't know. I mean, doesn't it people just kind of
push
the dream nature aspect of a picnic? Number two,
is there's another
mom was talking to her 4-year-old daughter.
Hi, Diego. Don't be Big Show, because I'm going to die if it's Big Show.
The mom tried to brush it off, but then the daughter started to
go. DJ Bro, Thunder Climbdown Champion! Number nine. I
mean, at this point, the mom is kind of freaking out because without even before she had never met anyone named Sally. No one has ever told her what comes to her. And here's the creepiest part. Whenever the mother is trying to tell her daughter that when someone dies, they go on with it forever. The daughter says, that's not true. We come back. You know, I think there's a movie called Sometimes They Come Back, but that's really not the same thing. And if I was that mom and I learned that my kid is a mom killer, I don't think I could ever trust that kid again. I mean, she says it was an accident. I don't know that. Number three, the little girl. This story comes from a babysitter who says that a few years ago, when she was pregnant, she was born to bed. It was about 50 at the time.
Bye.
The little girl didn't want to go to sleep.
Only 20 more superstars. So the part of the woman who should... Oh, in our car! Randy Orton is on the... Oh, crap!
...across the room at nothing and said... What about that little girl? My exact reaction if I never experienced something like that would be, first of all, pee my pants, and then crack the door before the ghost can slam it shut and just run out of the house. Now, before you judge the little girl behind, I just want to say, according to basically every single horror movie I've ever seen, the little girl and that ghost are probably best friends, so, you know, she's fine. Also, I do want to say, a lot of these horror movies, when the ghost shuts the door, seems to go trying to open it up with no success. You know what I would do? I would just jump out the window. I might break a leg, but that's much better than getting strangled by a little ghost. Number four, the person that posted this story said that when she was at her aunt's house, while going upstairs to the bathroom, she went to her cousin, the little girl, sitting on the stairs with familiar faces. She looked around, and of course, no one was there, so she asked April what she was doing. April, who was 4 at the time, said she was constantly looking at the brain.
Bye, game. You eliminated me.
She asked April what the lady was doing, and April said, making faces, which is pretty creepy already, but then April said this. Her brain is around her neck. The lady is pained by her brain.
So, it's suicide.
The girl who posted this story then said, April in the face of the left girl realized what was happening. Because April was making faces of someone gasping for air. Number five, the Titanic. The person who posted this story said that when his kid was 4 years old, they were watching a documentary of the Titanic together. When the scene of a picture of the schematics of the boiler room came on the screen, the camera came from left to right over the lens. The child pointed at the TV and said, that's wrong. The boilers were on the other side. And I was right here, as he pointed to a small space in the boiler room. That's where I was. That's why I don't like water now. Number six, the girl on the slide. A mom was sitting on her back porch watching her 3-year-old daughter play on the slide in her backyard when the daughter went up to her and asked her if she could play with the little girl on the slide. The mom didn't see a little girl and asked where this girl was.
My problem, man!
She's right on the slide. Mom, can I play with her? Mom said again that she doesn't see the mother or the girl, but the daughter insisted she's in the slide. Then the mom freaked out and took the daughter inside for the the rest of the day he kept looking out the window, saying that the little blue girl was lonely. Number 7, the drawing. The person who posted this story was babysitting a 5-year-old girl who drew a picture of a woman. No one has ever heard from that babysitter ever again.
Really?
Dude, love?
Number 8.
Dude, love.
This story
your face.
Wait, he's already been in this story one time.
At the grocery store, she went all hysterical when she saw this random guy. So much so that her and her mom had to leave the store. Where her mom asked her what was wrong when they got into the car, she said, "He took me away from my first mom." She refused to sit in the seat of the car, but instead cowered under the dashboard the whole ride home. And of course, her mom at the time was her biological mother, so who was the first one? Number 9, the closet. While changing her daughter in front of the open closet door, the little girl kept looking around the mom's bathroom. So the mom asked her what was so funny. The daughter replied, "The man was the first one."
Hey, they don't want timing!
The closet, he said.
I'm a fan.
Was there. He says that she's too afraid to look into the history of the house.
I'm attacking you, Hideo.
This is really short and it's really creepy.
You broke my knee. Now I'm gonna break you.
Remember that time
in this royal room.
And finally, number 11, the bad. The little girl was crying. And
bad man.
Why she was
crying. I'm gonna break
the little girl said, "Bad man."
You
the parents asked her,
"Bye, Hideo! Bye, Hideo!"
At a dark corner of the room and says, "There." As soon as the parents turn to look, a lamp on the bookcase next to that dark corner falls to the floor. But you know, I've been thinking about this. Maybe the little girl said, "Batman," which makes sense because Batman is always lurking in the shadows.
Fernando?
Now he owes this family a link. You need an explanation. You know, if I ever have kids, and if I ever see.
Bye, Fernando. I owe you.
Boom!
I faced you at WrestleMania 26.
Mike Vargo, if you ever get a kid and your kid, Mike Vargo, if your kid ever says something creepy like, "Hey Dad, remember that one time I was the dad and you were the kid and you were killed and then I tried to kill him," but if your kid ever says something, if your kid ever says something creepy,
what were I deadly?
Are you holding something? No. I look away. He's hiding our largest carving knife behind his back. Number 14. My 3-year-old nephew was at my cottage. He asked me numerous times about the girl over there while pointing out one of the back bedrooms.
That was nice! We're buds! What the heck? We're buds!
I don't think he likes you.
Cesaro!
Cesaro doesn't like
Cesaro
anyone.
Cesaro does not like me. Cesaro just... We're buds. It's me and Tyson King. We were tag team champions.
Tyson King?
I said kid. Tyson's I will miss you. Stop it, we're buds! I meant it. We're best buds. Kalisto! Ten more superstars left.
Whoa. I just don't understand. Whoa. He looked at me, and I remembered this word for word.
I was on a big, unsinkable ship. Whoa. We hit the biggest iceberg. No! And then I got the ring from the flag. I went to a warm, bright place, and I'll be number 30. My mom heard it and decided. Wait, my... I just saw 21 and I guessed it.
Son, who is about five at the time, walks out of his room one night at about
heck was that? What the heck was that? I heard something.
At the time, it heard the machine going. He went to investigate, then saw the puppy and realized what had happened. He figured that the kid just didn't know what he was doing and quickly removed the dead puppy to spare his son being traumatized. The kid saw his dad walk past the doorway and he went to check the washing machine. And I asked him, where is
it's Finn Balor!
Number four, my mom's dad died 10 years before I was born. I was about 6 or 7 when my parents divorced.
I hope you said wrong.
I was at the kitchen table buying her something while my mom went with me. She said I stopped instantly and looked toward the front door as if I heard something. I stared for a long time, then giggled, turned towards my mom, and said, Granddad says don't worry, everything will be okay, and he won't let anything bad happen. I then began humming and went back to my drawing. My mom says it's the single creepiest thing that's ever happened to her, and I have no memory of it happening. Number three.
We care about using cage-free eggs. And we care about amazing taste. Because of vegetables, we're on the side of food.
And I have no memory of it happening. Number three. When my daughter was 3, one day she said to me, don't you
know?
Before, when you were the daughter and I was the mother, they came and chopped all our hands off. Chop, 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 chop. The whole village. She made vicious chopping motions every time she
said, Eric.
Chop. I was so taken aback. All I could say was, fortunately, sweetheart, I don't remember the head chopping. Her response was, well, it happened, and I remember it really well. Number two, my daughter's
young.
There's a woman who watches her watch movies later.
Two more superstars coming.
She also says that it does not like me and wants to eat my heart. My kid watches Elmo the fucking dinosaur train. Where the hell did she get this from?
Holy.
When I was
That is so creepy.
What?
A kid said that there was a monster on top of her roof that she wants to eat her and eat her heart, and she watches Dinosaur Train in Elmo. Where did she get it from?
No, I had 2 grandmas, but I kept repeating that line over and over. Then the phone rang. It was my uncle calling to tell my mother that my grandma had passed a few minutes ago. Daddy, we looked at each other. I may or may not have screamed. Then we ran to my car and decided to drive to the one place that was open in our shitty small working town, Walmart.
What the frick?
As soon as we got in the car, we knew something had come with us.
Eliminate.
And pissed at us for leaving. The second we got into
what the frick? These people suck.
Still into both of us.
Eliminate him, Jane.
Whatever it was filled that car with hate.
We just eliminated.
It's now about 4 a.m. and I have to be at work in 5 hours. So we decided to go back to her house and try to get some sleep and see what happens. We walk into the front door and nothing but quiet. We walk up the stairs, turn right, and suddenly it sounds like a dog is growling from our upstairs bathroom. It takes me a second though, because I grew up with dogs, and all I could think was that it was just mine being weird. 5 seconds later, I realize I'm at her house, and no dog has ever set paw in there. Something was fucking growling at me, and I had no idea what.
Oh, that's
at this point,
pissed
at whatever is happening.
Because these people are going
to go to sleep for work. So
it's
I
YouTube
go on this dog. Brilliant plan, talking shit to whatever was causing all these problems. The only thing that sticks out at this point is me yelling, if you're so pissed off, do something about it. Right after that, I feel something totally sure. I turn around thinking my girlfriend is playing a very unfunny joke on me. But no, she was downstairs, and something pulled my shirt. After that, I decided
I'm going to WrestleMania.
At 6 a.m., I get in my car and drive from my mom's house. That car ride was much less evil.
If Finn Balor wins, he's gonna face the WWE champion.
I went to work and my girlfriend slept at my mom's place.
That's gonna be
and
a great match.
I went back to her house to
but
check
I'm
things.
Pretty sure
everything
he's
seemed
not
fine except for one picture of us she had hanging on her
because
wall.
I'm about to
was knocked to the
bad.
Ground.
Oh! Or not!
She was too exhausted
no,
to
no
care
time.
About my safety at that point. And I was
I'm
so
not
tired,
timing.
I was willing to let whatever was there kill
you
us.
You can just
so
do this all day.
Just get some rest. 2 weeks later, we moved out and haven't had any problems since. I never believed in the paranormal at all until this happened. I still question it. My brain thinks there has to be a logical explanation to all of it, and I'm sure there is. But I know she believes, and a piece of me believes, that there's something else in that house.
Your face.
14,
Oh yes. I'm eliminating you right now.
It's national park.
Why?
Everything's super cool.
Bulldog wins.
He's
going to face AJ Styles for the world championship.
And if you've ever been around these parts, you'll know. Just a little dirt road. And if you've ever been around these parts,
I believe once I kill the Ender Dragon and I go to the
and
thing, my house may seem small, but I'm gonna have an additional house. It's dark. Don't go. Don't mine at night. Well, dude, if you go, if you mine at night, you don't have to worry about the mouse. Finally, I was about to see my head.
My mother decided to sell the house.
I
never once had contact with the buyers. Only knew them by name. The buyers had a son who went to the same school as our old neighbors, dear friends of the family, and the son apparently came to school without sleep repeatedly, complaining there was a girl who watched him all night and that he needed to get out.
There it is, at WrestleMania.
So I get home from my job as a server at midnight. One of my roommates was in the Navy and was deployed at the time.
WrestleMania.
The other was at his girlfriend's house. I cook myself dinner, and as I'm cooking, my dog starts barking.
And up next, the world champion online against the British.
This is especially weird because she never ever barks. She was a rescue, and I brought her as a sense of security.
And yep, it is time.
And I could never get her to bark at anyone. I dismiss her barking as odd, but I finish cooking. I start to clean and turn the sink on because it takes forever to get hot. But right when I turned around, the sink turned off on its own. Again, I think it's odd.
The phenomenal world champion. Oh, I get that. The phenomenal world champion.
But no one is home, and it's midnight. So I figure I'd just tough it out, even though I was beginning to get a little squeezed. After cleaning, I go into the bathroom. My bathroom was small, with the sink immediately to your right as you enter, with the toilet next to it, bathtub at the end,
toilet paper
dispenser directly across the toilet. So I was sitting on the sink, and the toilet paper dispenser was right behind me.
After 2 to 3 minutes, I hear a weird noise behind me. So I turn around, and I shit you not, the whole
world championship
was a route fast as fuck. Like someone was pulling it. I noped the fuck out of the bathroom. The door was closed, and it had no windows, so it couldn't have been a breeze. I put a leash on my dog and would run out of that apartment faster than Usain Bolt. By the time this happened, none of my friends were awake, so I spent the night sitting outside the door of my apartment. When I get back in the next morning, the whole roll of toilet paper was on the ground, and the roll was probably 3/4 full. I'm talking a good 5 to 10 meters of toilet paper. After that day, I've never had an odd experience quite like that one ever again. But one of my roommates did mention that a few times he would come home and find every door and cabinet in the place open. I even specifically remember closing them and leaving them that way when he left. Number 12.
That's why I'm a little champion. A friend of
mine was taking a picture of herself and her daughter kissing.
Boom!
Check around the house and found nothing. After some research, they found one of the previous owners was a mortician or ran a funeral home or something. I have known this girl for years, and it would completely shock me if this was fabricated, as I saw
you might think you're strong, but you're not going to win your champion against me, because I'm a phenomenal champion.
Number 11. When I was around 6 or 7 years old, my uncle had just visited from the Philippines, showing us a doll that sent me like a Dixie spider. He pressed a button and brought it with the intention that one of my girl cousins might want it. But in all honesty, we all thought the doll was creepy, especially since it sang the song in a slow, ominous manner. Not knowing what to do with it, we took out the batteries and threw it back in the box that we had put it in right after we left the room. All we heard was a muffled Itsy spider came up with the water spout. The doll was singing with no fucking batteries. No one was in the room at the time, which means
swish.
That no one could press the batteries. No one pressed the button on her hand. Number 10. I have a ghost that occasionally visits me in my sleep. Things that people are hiding.
Oh yeah.
It's a female, and from the looks of what she's wearing, she's either from the 30s or 40s. Things I can recall off the top of my head. When I was in high school, she told me that one of my friends was going to break his leg when playing a sport he usually doesn't. The next day, this happened.
And
she told me that a girl I had a crush on was going to give me a number.